Okay. Looks like it's getting over on Restream. And it looks like it's coming to YouTube. Let me post it over to Discord. Oh, I didn't have Discord loaded. That would help. That would help. And we'll go here. At live, at everyone, send now. Okie doke. Cool. Welcome, everybody. It looks like we should be live. Adam Patrick Murray here with Willis Lai. How you doing today, Willis?
Hello. Good, good. How's everyone doing?
If you're anything like me, you're probably a little warm here in the Bay Area. We're having a heat wave, and it might not sound hot. You know, I used to live in Phoenix, so I still wouldn't call this hot, but houses don't have AC here, so, you know, it can get a little toasty. And hopefully the PC stays cool. So far so good. We're here to play some more Halo. Elena will be joining us in a second. I don't think we'll quite beat it today. It says we got 11 out of 15. We're going to hopefully get pretty damn close and maybe play it tomorrow as well. So let's dive right into it, Willis. Resume co-op campaign. Yeah. So
yeah, I'm excited to continue after the cliffhanger from the last one.
Yeah, this tentacle monster is an interesting part of it. Let me know how the audio sounds. I need to pump the game audio a little bit or whatnot. And we got Troll McTrollington, good name. Says Toronto has a heat wave as well. Yeah, I think everyone's getting a little warm. Oh boy,
super warm today. Oh no, what's gonna happen to Master Chief?
Yeah, hide your eyes. Not safe for work. That's cryptic. Oh, and there's the Arbiter.
Oh.
Relax. I'd rather not piss this thing off.
Demon.
Hello.
Hey, Elena's here.
Elena.
Welcome. We're getting introduced to the Grave Mind.
And has its mind concluded?
Nana. None of this lore actually resonates. I can't remember any of it.
Kill me or release me, parasite. But do not waste my time with talk. There is much talk, and I have listened through rock and metal and time. Now I shall talk, and you shall listen.
Greetings.
Ah, yes.
I am 2401 Penitent Tangent.
He's back.
I am Her of Installation 05.
And I am the Prophet of Regret, Counselor Most.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Hierarch of the Covenant.
A Reclaimer? Here? At last. We have much to do. This facility must be activated if we are to control this outbreak.
Stay where you are. Nothing can be done until my sermon is complete.
Not true. This installation has a successful utilization record of 1.2 trillion simulated in one actual. It is ready to fire on demand.
Of all the objects our lords left behind, there are none so worthless as these oracles. They know nothing of the great journey.
And you know nothing about containment. You have demonstrated complete disregard for even the most basic protocols.
That voice actor sounds different.
And this one's great journey are the same. Your prophets have promised you freedom from a doomed existence. But you will find no salvation on this ring. Those who built this place knew what they wrought. Do not mistake their intent, or all will perish. perish as they did before.
This thing is right. Halo is a weapon. Your prophets are making a big mistake.
Your ignorance already destroyed one of the sacred rings, demon. It shall not harm another. If you will not hear the truth, then I will show it to you. There is still time to stop the key from turning. But first, it must be found. You will search one likely spot, and you will search another. Fate had us meet as foes, but this ring will make us brothers.
No.
Okay.
We are, all of us, gravely concerned. The release of the parasite was unexpected, unfortunate, but there is no need to panic.
It's only two prophets left.
This is a time to rejoice.
Oh, look at that camera.
A moment that all
is that the,
C-2000? For the sacred icon has been found. With it, our path is clear.
What kind of lens is that?
The divine beyond guaranteed. The great journey is nigh, and nothing, not even the flood, can stop it.
Oh.
Oh.
Boo.
Boo.
Nice.
I'm on a time delay, so I'm just waiting for her.
Well, Master Chief just showed up. Spoilers.
To
wreck the sermon. It was kind of funny.
Hey, everybody. Did you wait for me? Guess not.
Brutes! The faster you can kill those brutes, the better.
Quest 1134 wants to know why we have to mention every time that we're on an EGPU. We know already, is what they said, but, you know, we sometimes get new people in the stream, so it's nice to let them know.
The demon has infiltrated the council chamber! Protect the Hierarchs! Seal the exit!
Oh, I don't think...
Are you guys playing now?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
You're so quiet today.
I'm sorry. You know, it is hot. I feel low energy. And I just shot a review video for the Razer Opus.
Oh, did you?
It'll be up over on Tech Advisor. And yeah, I kind of spent all my heat energy filming that. It was fun, though.
It is so warm. I didn't catch it. How warm is it on the East Bay side right now?
Very warm.
Yeah, I mean, it's probably warmer where Willis is than Alameda, because at least I'm kind of closer to the beach. So I've noticed it's a little bit cooler than the main Oakland and Berkeley.
Yeah.
I think it's like 86, maybe? I would stop and look at my phone. Maybe I'll do that when there's the next cutscene.
Do you guys have AC in your places?
No.
Alright, so it's just like San Francisco then.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, none of my places I've lived at in Oakland have had AC. Pretty uncommon, I think. Even in the East Bay.
Okay, how's that chat? Am I still too loud?
People are complaining about hearing you?
It's so weird. It's always so weird, right? Like, we use Zoom, I'm too soft, we use Discord, it can be too loud, so... Put me down on one of the they're saying the game is quiet, by the way.
Oh, yeah, okay.
To answer your question, Troll McTrollington, I really love that username, I believe Adam actually paid for the EGPU enclosure, because it's part of his setup at home.
Yes, yeah, they did not
send it to
me.
It's not sponsored content.
Nope, they did not send it to me, It was purchased based off of the decisions I had made looking at the landscape out there. There was a nice where's this console? We're supposed to set it down at. There it is. There was a nice website called EGPU.io, I believe it was. I can't remember off the top of my head, but it kind of breaks down a lot of the features of each EGPU. Size-wise and specs. It was actually a really nice a nice tool when I was looking at which one I wanted to use.
Prima 7-11, nice to have you join us.
Man, I need a better weapon. I just have this stupid pistol.
Alright, I'm gonna wait for the delay to catch up. Let me know if I'm still too loud now.
Yeah, and the music's a little louder now too, so hopefully.
Right this way. Ah.
Dude, back off, back off. Thank you, Willis.
Punch him.
Yeah.
Beat down. Here's Cortana.
Did you put the pinata skull on?
Yes. Yep,
that's back on.
Yeah.
Already got a couple headshots already.
Oh yeah. No, pinata skull on, where if you punch them, grenades come out.
Oh, really? No.
Yeah, it's great.
That's a good one.
Yeah, it's only for the grunts.
Yeah, it's just all the same specs we've had. Yay! 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 Four headshots in a row. It's like a party. It's like a birthday party. It's not even my birthday anymore.
Joe, thank you for the feedback. That helps. So Eric Johnson wants to know who's in charge of the verticals and horizontals. That would still be Mr. Adam Patrick Murray.
Yep.
So you're watching his screen right now as he blazes on through.
Yeah.
Yay, hooray!
Unfortunately, we don't have a PC tower over at Willis's house to handle streaming and the game. He's just running off a laptop, so.
Yeah.
But, I mean, now that we got the new orders, I think we should maybe look into it. You picking it
That's
up?
Where'd
that
you go?
That view is really nice. Actually.
The what is?
Out in the distance. Out in the distance, the view is pretty nice.
Oh, yeah.
Where'd you go, Willis? I lost you.
Oh, I'm right below. I dropped down and I thought I was going to fall and die, but it's actually the next.
Oh, okay.
There you go. Hey. Yeah, and then.
And I'm dead.
Did you die?
I died.
What? How? Oh, you didn't land on this.
The little pad, no.
This little pad right here.
Well, thanks for doing all the mopping.
Waiting to see Adam die.
Yeah, I died.
It was hilarious. I haven't gotten there yet. YouTube chat is saying that you're actually a little bit on the low side for your mic, Adam, so I don't know if you want to adjust yours at all, but in Discord you sound about the same as Willis, so don't know.
Well, remember it's a split mic setup. I haven't implemented that.
Oh, that's right, that's right. Yet, so you might want to turn the gain up on your siren.
Yeah, I just noticed on the podcast last week I was a little hotter than everybody else, so I always try to adjust. But
I know.
I think in the future, with the new setup, we'll get a little better on that. Back off, dude. Back off. I died. Oh, man. Yeah, I feel like I have, like, a heat headache right now. That's never
Are you
fun.
Drinking enough water?
I should probably drink more water. Yeah. Good call.
And definitely keep hydrated during this, like, heat wave.
You think I would learn that when I lived in Phoenix for so long, but sometimes I forget. Beer has water in it, right? I mean, getting plenty of beer.
It also has alcohol, which is diuretic, I believe.
I've got the Metamucil to balance it out, so.
Oh, God. You're an old man already at your age.
Now, hey, you know what? Bowel health is a good thing for all ages. Not just the.
Yeah, but you
people.
Could get your fiber naturally, and then you would get, like, vitamins and nutrients at the same time.
It's true. Luckily, I'm not overloading on fiber, so.
That's gotta suck. I have to say, I'm watching the stream now, and, like, can you imagine, like, waking up and someone dude just, like, blasting you in the face? That's gotta suck. Hey, we have Overclock or Blue Devil from OCN in our chat.
Hello.
Hanging out with
hey.
Us saying,
what's going
saying
on?
They're playing Halo 2 as well.
Oh, yeah. You know, I like this game. I still like it. Willis, do you still like it?
I'm loving it. Thanks.
Is it hurting your soul that we haven't beat it yet? We've been playing it like once a week for the past 3 weeks.
Hey, we're just savoring it, so it's okay.
Gosh.
Saving the moment.
Adam, you have a defender in chat. Adrian Gonzalez says that I guarantee that Adam's audio balance and levels are more correct than everyone else's. It's probably true, but we don't have a mixer or anything fancy like him, so he unfortunately has to adjust to us.
I mean, yeah, it's a hairy situation for even the most experienced audio engineer. We don't do NDI or anything like that. It's all old school. Over the internet, everyone's doing it themselves. This is the way we came, I think.
S7473 said that on their first foreign holiday in a hot country, they fainted after drinking and being too dehydrated.
Yikes.
They're just saying that, yeah, alcohol dehydrates, so be careful.
Oh yeah.
Yeah,
and actually I was talking to the UK guys this morning. And they had a bank holiday yesterday, and they said it's also a heat wave going on, even in the UK. So, it's adding insult to injury. You've got to be home. There's AC in the office, you know, that was always a nice thing.
Yeah.
But, no, we don't get that luxury. Yay!
Dude, chat's getting dark. Replied to S7473 saying, I worked with someone who died like that.
Overdose? Or no, I'm
probably dehydration, like heat stroke or something. Yikes. Yeah.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's serious. It's serious business. You know, a lot of people think alcohol will keep you warm in the cold. That doesn't work
it
like that either.
You feel warm, but it actually makes your body release heat it needs to keep.
Yeah.
Because it opens up all your blood vessels.
That stupid Saint Bernard that, you know, rolls around with the ale around its neck. What a jerk. It's actually killing us. Yay!
Hooray!
Oh, I think I was supposed to go down. I think you went around the right way.
Yep.
The
Marines are just inside.
Careful of the guard. Oh, gosh. Primus 711 says it's 102 degrees in Sacramento, and that is why I do not miss living in Sacramento. Ooh.
Yeah, it's funny.
Man,
go ahead.
No, thank you.
Yeah, the first time I went during it was the state fair. I can't remember the time frame, but it was like June or something. Anyway, yeah, I did not realize that Sacramento was so much hotter than. Oh, who is that?
Oh,
hey, dude, what's up? Who's this new guy? This ain't
is
Frank.
Is it Jimmy? Or Frank?
No, this is Frank. What's up, dude? God, I haven't seen you forever. How you been, man? Yeah, you miss me? Yeah? You're not going to say anything, huh? You're just going to stone cold Frank. Silent. But man, he still has that eye twitch,
I
tell you
what. I'm 5 seconds behind, but did you just throw a plasma grenade onto the face of a grunt you just killed and used it to blow up other people? Because that's pretty great.
I think it was his foot, but yeah. Oh, I think, okay. I think these are prisoners. We released the prisoners, I think is what we did.
So Frank never died. He was just captured.
Yeah, he just got captured. Man, I'm so glad I found you, dude. But hey, listen. You gotta keep up. Wait. More guards, dude. Get ready. Okay, come on. Also, pick up a different weapon. Oh, there's three guys. We got Frank, we got Jimmy, and we got somebody else.
J.R. Richardson, to answer your question about live chat on YouTube. Yeah, so we're answering questions for our game streams just from the YouTube live chat. We're just kind of hanging out with everybody.
And Twitch.
When we're talking about Discord, we're talking about our voice chat connection with each other. So we're on a voice call with each other right now through Discord. And so when we're talking about levels and stuff like that, that's what we're referring to.
Yeah, everyone on the stream is hearing the output of our Discord chat. Except for me, they're hearing my mic straight into OBS. All right, we got Jimmy.
Got two microphones.
We got Jimmy. We got Frank, and we got where's the third
Jimmy
one? Oh, there
Frank.
He is. Who's this? Wait, who said that?
Orson.
Okay, yeah, Orson. What's up, Orson? Oh, wait, also one of them sounds Mexican.
He spoke Spanish.
Accent. Yeah, he said amigo. So
was that Frank? I think it was Frank.
No, Frank. He's a white guy. I think it's wait. You know, they all look so generic, I can't really tell the difference. But that's not racist, that's just character models in the game. Anyway, oh yeah, Sacramento. Yeah, I didn't, you know, because I lived in Phoenix multiple times in my life.
That's so hot.
And, yeah. Though,
you know, it's as bad as Phoenix sometimes.
Yeah, I will say, you know, when I lived in Phoenix for a bit, when you get to a certain temperature, like, I always felt like anytime up to 110, yeah, it got hot and hotter, but after 110, whatever. It's the same. You don't, like, I think the highest temperature I ever personally experienced was, like, 124. So, like, the jump from 110 to 124, I couldn't really tell the difference. But from 100 to 110, you know,
wait,
I could definitely
feel
that.
You don't want a rocket launcher?
No, especially not in tight quarters like this. I would definitely kill myself. Also, I have no idea where we're supposed to go.
Yeah.
I feel like we're supposed to go on this pad, right? Like, it would take us up? Because none of these...
I feel like the...
doors are
difference
open.
Between Phoenix and Sacramento too is that y'all get thunderstorms at some point, so you get a little bit of like release, like,
oh,
so like the rain comes and it cools off just a touch, so it's not quite so terrible, and like you're just baking in the sun, but Sacramento is just super dry.
Oh well, I mean, Phoenix is definitely a desert, but yeah, I mean, you get those like crazy storms, which are awesome. Do you know about Haboobs?
No.
Yeah, it's you should Google Haboob. It's something unique to.
Are you trolling me?
No, I'm not. H A B O B. No, H A B O O B. I think is what it is. It's like literally like something out of Independence Day, the movie, where it's just like this huge wall of a dust storm like coming towards you, and it's just like crazy. Now I think we're supposed to go up.
Oh.
Yeah. And supposedly Phoenix is, like, unique in... there's only a couple places in the world that get Haboobs, and Phoenix is one of them, and it's trippy. When it happens and you're in the middle of one, like, it's knocking, like, little pieces of, you know, of sand and dirt everywhere, and it's just, like, yeah, it's pretty bad. It feels like post-apocalyptic in a lot of ways, especially when you see like just this massive wall heading towards you. Everyone's like, ah, get inside. You don't want to be caught out in a Haboob. I don't think I ever got any like really good photos of it personally.
It's kind of a shame.
Usually I would just retreat indoors.
Primus, that's true. I mean, yeah, if it's good, a good night, then you get the breeze. But sometimes, I remember sometimes I'd be out in my place in Davis and I would just be lying on the floor, on the kitchen tile floor, because there was no breeze that night, and it just sucked.
Well, it just, this, I mean, I assume Sacramento people have AC units, right? At least.
You do, but I mean, like, okay. I was living up there, you know, when I was in college and a little bit after college, so... You know, you don't have a lot of money then, so you don't want to... I mean, I could have, but I didn't want to blow my money on paying for the electric bill, so...
That sounds like an Elena thing.
No, Willis probably would have done the same.
I'm pretty sure.
Alright, well, yeah. In Phoenix, yeah, you just blare it. Yeah, you go from one cold spot to another. Actually, I would say a lot of times, like, sometimes places like grocery stores would, like, overcompensate to the point where, like, you'd actually, like, feel almost, like, freezing.
Oh, yeah. When I was in my office building, I have to wear a sweater.
Yeah, you go from, like, heat to icy cold. It's like a 50-degree swing. Human body's not really meant for that. But
Adam, you've been to Taiwan in the summer for Computex. How would you say how to compare to Phoenix heat?
Last year we were lucky because last year there was like a ton of rain, so it cooled stuff down. Like we got a lot of cloud cover, so like we actually didn't get too hot.
Yeah.
Like, if anything, it was the humidity, which, to be fair, I hate even, like, 10% humidity. I hate humidity. So, you know, humidity is what killed me. It actually wasn't too hot, luckily. But the heat and humidity? Yeah, right. Kill me now.
Also, hello, Matthew Lang. Thanks for joining us.
Hello. That's nice the birthday boy, right?
Hello. Yeah.
Last week, yeah.
Yeah.
Last week.
I'm glad he didn't die of alcohol poisoning.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, Singapore is super humid.
I died. Oh, okay.
Oh no. Oh my.
Yeah, the most humid place I ever lived was Pittsburgh.
East Coast is real humid.
Yeah, and it's still, what, 6 hours from the coast, I think? But even then, like, yeah. It was bad enough, especially for me. And that was the first time, too, I found out about humidity in the winter. You know, because you always think, humidity in the summer just sucks. But in the winter, it just, like, becomes this, like, biting cold that no matter how many layers you put on, it just, goes all the way to the bone.
Like, yeah.
Oh, man. So, like, you get double dose. Humidity just sucks.
I agree.
I mean,
it's
good for the skin, but, nah. I'd rather be a wrinkly old man. Personally.
The elites have failed to protect the prophets.
Troll McTrollington, pretty much if you're by water, it increases the humidity. So, like, San Francisco, even though it doesn't get as hot when it gets hot, it can feel just really gross because, I mean, we're right by the water.
You know what, the weird thing, I was really worried about the humidity in the Bay Area, but even for me, who, like, hates humidity, I actually don't find it that bad, especially compared to, like, Pittsburgh or other places.
Well, it doesn't get as hot, it doesn't get as cold, right? So
yeah,
true. Yeah, definitely.
But the rare days that we have 90 plus degree weather, fun.
Oh,
man.
No, I forgot our guys are with us, and I just I think,
did you kill your team again?
Yeah,
Adam,
one of them's dead, but
did
you know.
You kill Frank?
Let's see.
Oh, no.
I gotta,
what are you gonna say to his parents?
Two people are dead.
Jeez.
Oh, no, now all three are dead. I'm gonna say,
no.
Yeah, I'm just gonna say they got captured, you know, because that's what happened last time. We found them in prison, and then, you know, so hopefully maybe they just got captured again.
Moral of the story, don't team up with Adam if you want to live.
I mean, that's true, especially if I'm driving. I'm a risk taker. We need to get behind this guy.
I just saw them die. That's tragic.
Yeah. I mean, I did everything I could to save them, but... Yeah.
Did you?
At least they died in the line of duty.
You shot their knee instead of their face?
No, I threw a grenade. You know, and I didn't say grenade out.
Right in close proximity.
Yeah, but hey, listen, you know, like... I had to do what I had to do. Decisions were made. As a commanding officer, you know, you just sometimes
their commanding
have to...
officer, you don't even have to tell their parents. That's why you're doing it, because you don't have to care.
Yeah.
Ooh,
no,
someone has a nice sniper rifle there. I like that one.
Oh yeah, the music kicking in. It's a little cheery for what I remember this level. Oh no, that guy. Oh, I'm out of grenades. Oh, I'm stuck on some weird vegetation. Oh, he's down. That was easy.
I think I headshot him.
Nice.
Yay. The sniper.
I think we're going the right way.
Rick Elder says, don't go with Adam if you want to live.
Don't go with Adam if you want to live. Yeah, that's what I say all the time. Arnold recorded that voice line just for me. Wait, somebody's shooting at us, and I... Oh.
Yeah.
No, Adrian Gonzalez, no, it's actually true. I mean, if you're, like, hovering in the 30s, if we're going by freedom units, if you're hovering in the 30s, humidity does actually influence how the cold feels.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
If you go below that, then that's when I think humidity doesn't really affect things, because, you know, freezing temperature of water and all that, but...
Yeah. I mean, yeah, it gets pretty low in Phoenix, or in Pittsburgh. And maybe I just wasn't ready for it, but oh boy.
Yeah.
I don't remember this level at all. Oh. Yay!
Look, California is never gonna... Sorry, Adrian. California is never gonna have anything on New York about the weather. We just like to complain about it. I know that especially if you're in New York City, you prefer winter because then you can't smell the garbage. That's what I've been told by people who live in Manhattan. We don't have that problem here, but we do have to worry about stepping in a lot of poop. So, you know, every city has their ups and downs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's only...
And also...
Go ahead.
Like, I was going to say, also, miscellaneous liquids on our public transportation, aka BART.
Well, I'm pretty sure New York has that problem, too. I mean, it's a big city.
Also... You know what it is. It's not miscellaneous if you know what it is. I mean,
yeah, it's only, you can smell it.
Yeah. I mean, it's, you know, you can't say, you know, it's, oh, you know, it could be soda. You know, nah, it's not soda.
It wouldn't smell so bad if it was soda.
And it's definitely not coffee, because hipsters don't want to, you know,
no,
lose their...
hipster coffee costs like $5 for espresso. Whoops. So they're not going to waste that.
I miss Blue Bottle. I'm going to tell you what. I always like getting Blue Bottle.
Do you
every once in a while.
Blue Bottle?
Yeah, I would always get the New Orleans, which is a cold brew with I'm dead, yeah. By the way. Okay, I'm back.
I didn't realize you were so bougie.
Oh, yeah, so fancy.
Bougie Adam.
Bougie, yeah, that was my nickname in high school. Bougie Adam.
Had a bougie. Oh my god, you fell off a cliff. This makes me feel so much better about my playthrough.
Oh yeah.
Earlier this week.
No, it happens. Which, you know, if anyone wants to see Elena play some Halo. Right?
Yeah, I started doing a little bit of personal streaming this week just to see what it's like, so... Yeah. Leif and I were playing earlier.
You want to share your
Sunday?
Your Twitch handle or no?
Oh yeah, I mean I'm 16-bit Relic on Twitch. I only have one stream that I've done so far. Might do one tonight. I don't know. We'll see how it goes in my evening plans. The thing is though, is I have so much respect for solo streamers because I don't know how they do it. Like they keep everything rolling and it's just one person. Like, I'm so used to this where I have people to talk to, bounce off of, have someone, you know, moderating chat or handling chat. So, mad respect for them.
I mean, there definitely is a personality type that excels at Twitch. That's for sure. The counselors gather on Halo to see the icon
safely. Yeah, I definitely walked off a cliff on Sunday. I was like, oh, well, I'm dead. They're like, what happened? Well, I walked off the cliff like the talented individual that I am. God.
Yeah, one of the worst feelings is being warm enough that your forearms are like wet on your desk. Like my forearms are like making my table surface wet. And that sucks. I hate that feeling. But I'm just going to sit in it. There's nothing I can do about it.
You could put a towel under it.
I mean, I could.
You know, you could.
I could, but then the towel's just going to get wet, you know? Like, I don't want to ruin a perfectly good towel.
I mean, you still, you know what? You do you.
Or, I will say something else I could get is, you're on the Razer email blast, right?
I think I'm on some of them.
Yeah, you know, I should... Let me take a pause right here.
Matthew Lang on YouTube's like, Adam accidentally kills his teammates and walks off cliffs.
Oh, and I just got killed as I was looking at this.
Oh my god.
Wait, sorry, I'm just double checking I didn't do it. I'm not going to talk about anything here.
Adrian, I am not here to besmirch New York City's character or reputation. I'm just going by what friends were telling me when I was visiting in 2017. I was there in March, so it was still cold, so it's not like I could smell anything. But someone who was living there, because she's like a dancer, and she was saying that, yeah, summertime gets a little fragrant sometimes.
I mean, I don't like New York. I can say it sucks.
But no, that, I love New York. It has a great energy, and my favorite part about it is that, unlike San Francisco, there are people who actually pay attention when they're walking down a sidewalk, and you know, are considerate of other people and are not just glued to their phones, not paying attention to anybody.
Yeah. Will, speaking of glued, my forearms are still glued to my desk, but. Back to the transition I had. Razer just released the the Gigantus V2, and I died again. Which you should go to Razer.com and look at the Gigantus V2 because they have the largest mouse mat I think I've ever seen, and I want it so bad. It looks truly huge. The 3XL size is 47 inches by 21 inches. That's like 47 inches. That's like what, 4 feet? No, I'm not bad at math.
Almost. It's almost 48 inches, which would be 4 feet.
Yeah. So like, man, yeah, I
well,
was actually
don't
thinking,
fall off the edge. Don't fall off the edge.
I'm back. I'm thinking of picking
actually
one
nerve wracking watching you.
I love huge mouse mats, and I think that is like the biggest mouse mat available out there.
I feel like you should break out into a parody version of that Sir Mix-a-Lot song.
I like big mats, and I cannot lie. Yeah. it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool.
Why do you like mouse mats so much?
You know, because it was always like, I think it was...
You use a trackball.
Well, I use both. I have both on my setup, so it's nice to have everything all on one mouse mat, including my keyboard, you know, because then everything's on the same field and you're not getting like uneven surface feel. I'm dead too. Good job, team. I can't even use it right now. It's not like this table would allow it. Actually, I don't even think the surface at work is big enough to hold this gigantic. But yeah, I like it, and part of the reason why I like it is because Gordon doesn't get it either, so that's always fun. Anything to spite Gordon.
You just
Gordon
trolling
is,
Gordon?
Yeah. Anything to spite Gordon
you should,
is always...
What you should do, Adam,
yes,
is you should get one, roll it out, set up your system at work, and then play with the controller in front of him at that desk.
I'll have a controller, a trackball, and a mouse, and a keyboard all on one pad, you know? And instead of putting down a towel, you know, hopefully that mat, just my forearms don't stick to it, so, you know.
Oh, Rick Elder wants to know if the Steam controller experiment is still over for you now, or is it still going?
You know, I haven't got myself to do a video about it, but yeah, I think I'm over it right now.
You were so in love.
You know,
are you a fickle person, Adam?
No.
With your affection?
No, the thing is, number one, I actually do really like it. I think it's a good controller. But, like, I think for me what it boils down to is patience. Even though I gave it a good, like, 6 months or something, like, I still felt like I was scratching the surface with it. I felt like I needed to continue to dedicate to it. But the hard part was in those cases where, if I was on Epic Game Store or Blizzard, playing Call of Duty, I would go back to the Xbox Series, the Elite Series 2, and just be like, oh yeah, this just, you know, it's like a warm blanket. You just like snuggle right in, and it's, you know, you're back home.
It's fine, yeah, I don't know.
Oh. And so, yeah, I still like it. I still think, you know, there's damn good uses for it. But yeah, honestly, there's can give us a good checkpoint. There was a patent filed for a V2. So I think when a V2 comes out, I will definitely pick it up and try it out again. Ah. there were certain things that you know, just I wish were better. Like the face buttons were a little too close together. The lack of rumble. I know it sounds trivial, but you know, I didn't like the experimental force feedback that they had instead of traditional rumble. You know, USB-C charging is just another thing I have to hold on. USB mini, no, micro USB charging is just another thing I have to still hold on to, relic of the past. Luckily, I'm quickly running out of, you know, pieces of gear that need it.
You don't get adapters? That's what I find works the best for me.
Yeah, I mean, I have adapters, you know, I don't... They're usually... It adds another, like, little length to it that, you know, another area that you have to worry about breaking. I don't know. USB-C everything. I'm on that train.
I just wish they would get the transition over with, because that's the most annoying part.
Also, I think it's harder for... I feel like a lot of people who love the Steam controller came to it from mouse and keyboard, where for me, I'm coming to it from a controller. You know, so like I think mouse and keyboard players adapt to it easier than controller players.
I would agree with
that. Makes sense. And maybe I'm wrong on that point, but it just, yeah. You know, and then, you know, and that's putting aside, you know, like I've heard from a lot of people that, you know, it's very customizable, which is great for people who have any sort of disabilities that they need to work around. So, you know, I'm fortunate to not have to worry about that. But, you know, like supposedly a lot of people just swear by it because of the amounts that you can kind of customize it to your own liking. So, like, I definitely think it has a place. I'm definitely not poo-pooing it. I still love it. I just... Yeah, especially during this time of lockdown, like I've got other stresses to worry about. When I want to play a game, that was also what it boiled down to, is like, oh man, do I really want to just sit here and bang my head against learning a new thing at this point when I just want to play a game? Some things have to give in this quarantine, and the Steam controller was a unfortunate one to give. So that was long-winded, but I am actually excited if they do make a V2.
Well, we'll see if it pans out.
I mean, honestly, I could almost see them, because you know they make the controllers for the what's their headset? It's not the Vive. It's the I can't remember the Valve headset. Oh my god, why can't I think of it? Anyway, like, they're making controllers right now. Valve is making controllers. It's just, you know, for use in VR. So I would love to see them take what they learned from the Steam controller and what they've learned from the Index, Valve Index. There we go. Jesus Christ. And then funnel that into a Steam controller version 2.
Oh. Dead.
Yep. Oh, somebody behind me. Great. I mean, I'd almost be down for them to try like a Switch kind of thing where in the Index, obviously, it's two detached controllers, one for each hand. I could almost see that being an interesting way to go with the Steam controller version 2. Because once again, that was one of the things that also irked me, was I never got used to the gyro.
Yeah.
So
like, there's a lot. Not a lot, but there's people in chat saying that it does feel more natural coming from mouse and keyboard to gyro aim.
So, yeah, I feel like if they were two standalone controllers that you held in one in each hand, that might actually end up working better, especially for gyro. I mean, crap, maybe they'll make it so that the Index... Actually, I don't know the button they had on the Index. Yeah. I wonder if you could use the Index controller for traditional games. That might be interesting. But, yeah. I mean, maybe the Index is already Steam Controller version 2, but people haven't thought of it that way.
Hey, do you guys use mechanical keyboards?
I mean, I do at work. I don't hear because I need it quiet for streams and because I share a household. So, unfortunately, I don't have a mechanical right now.
Yeah, neither do I.
Oh, okay. So, I don't either because I use ergonomic equipment and they don't have mechanical ergonomic keyboards, like the specialty ergo keyboards, not like, you know, your more typical mainstream Microsoft or Logitech ones. So unfortunately, some guy, we're not able to help you out with that answer. You might want to stop in Discord and ask that question, just because I know Ziv, who's lurking somewhere in the YouTube chat, is probably busy working. He is really into like mechanical keyboards and custom switches and all that, so he might be able to answer that.
Is he asking about recommendations or?
No, they're asking like how often we have to replace the switches. They were saying that they were fixing their keyboard on Saturday, and they've already encountered more sticky keys.
Huh, interesting. Actually, yeah. Another good person to ask is our resident keyboard expert, Hayden Dingman.
All right, Hayden.
I think on Twitter he's HDC. Could be wrong. But I'm sure if you just search Hayden Dingman, you'll see him there. He's a freelance writer for PC World.
Yeah, he's our games writer.
Yeah, so yeah, I'd be curious to hear that too. I've never personally heard of like too many switches going out, but I'm sure it's possible. Then again, I've pretty much only used Cherries. Actually, no, that's not true because I've been using at work. I have the Huntsman Elite, or the Huntsman. I can't remember. It's the Razer Purple, which is the Optomechanical. I love that keyboard, man. I miss that keyboard. I wish I could bring it to home, but yeah, it's not going to work here.
Too loud?
Yeah, it's too loud. It takes up too much space. You know, like I'm not sitting at a desk right now. I'm literally just sitting at a round coffee table that's this wide. That's like what? 2.5, maybe 3 feet. So yeah, I'm cramped for space. But I will say, I have been looking at desks. I might have to eat into even more of our living room space. And just say,
does that mean you give up the eGPU and get a desktop PC? Or
I mean, right now I've only been using the eGPU for these gaming sessions. Like once I'm done with that video that I'm gonna have, like unless people really want to know like how it performs in like creative apps, which I wasn't gonna do in this video. It's just not gonna work for me. It's just it's so weird because when I started out with this eGPU thing, you know, we didn't have this scenario that we're in, so I didn't.
Oh, specifically for streaming, you mean?
Well, no, just like, you know, working from home full time. So like. I didn't expect I was going to have to take up most of my living room for work. So now that I'm already taking up most of my living room for work, you know, like I don't need to worry too much about getting an eGPU set up. So
fair.
Yeah, I might just bite the bullet at this point and just, yeah, like take up more than half of the room with a desk. Yeah.
Yeah,
because it would be nice having a, you know, more surface area, especially if I'm going to try to do more pre-recorded video.
Yeah,
it's been fine for streaming. Yeah, I need like a surface to you know, shoot B-roll on and whatnot. So yeah, so the eGPU thing, even if COVID dries up, oh man, why did I jump off the edge like that? I don't know. Even if COVID dries up or you know, it's all gone tomorrow, yeah, I think I would then go into a small form factor, because that's the other thing too, is yeah, I don't know.
Split them up, one in each phantom.
It's hard, this work from home stuff complicated everything. But I don't feel like the investment I made in the eGPU enclosure is a bad deal. Like, it still has its uses.
My faith is strong. I will not fail.
Yeah.
I actually wanted to try an HDP setup when they first started coming out, but so far just been. I am currently surrounded. Not even surrounded. I have a cluster of desktop systems right now off to my right. So I have the one that I'm using right now to talk to you guys on the stream, and then I have like the dual streaming PC setup right next to it, and then I have my home PC behind me. So a lot of tech in this room right now.
I'm sure that doesn't make it warm at all.
Oh my goodness. I finally realized that. So back when I was reviewing the Intel Ghost Canyon NUC, it was kind of cold in San Francisco, and I didn't have any problems, even though this room tends to get cold. And then I figured out why. It's because the Ghost Canyon NUC pours out heat, and then actually this system I built for streaming also pours out a decent amount of heat. So I'm a little uncomfortable in the room right now.
Yeah, I haven't been folding on my HP Omen Obelisk, which is barred from the office because, yeah, that thing pours out heat. Luckily, my PC that I used to have at home, it actually runs pretty cool. And that's what I'm using to stream, like encode the stream right now. I've been lucky with that. That one I pimped out with a ton of case fans and whatnot. Yeah, so.
So, are we switching over to the Arbiter now?
I'm not sure. I don't remember what
happened. His side of the story?
Yeah, I thought we only went to him twice, but yeah, looks like we're going to him the third time. I will say the C200, well, the C100 has fans on it as well, but they never really tended to kick in. The C200, it's got some fans, and boy, they kick in. I was not
your
expecting
new camera?
That new camera to throw off heat. I mean, it's...
Oh, I didn't realize it had built-in fans.
Oh, yeah. These cinema cameras, they need fans.
I have no idea.
All that. I mean, this thing records 10-bit RAW internally. Wait, no. 8-bit RAW internally.
Oh.
Onto CFast cards. I mean, this... Yeah. And it's a big body. It's like... Not quite double the size of the C100, but...
Are you kidding? The C100 is what we had at CES, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Jeez, it's double the size?
Yeah, I mean, it's the body itself. I mean, you could just Google it, you know, C100 versus
Good
C200.
Grief.
It's
really am
going
to have to keep working out if you're going to be handing me that thing during events.
No, that's the thing. That's why I'm still keeping the C100s around, because at events... I don't need to shoot and edit in 4K at events, so I'm gonna stick with 1080p. The C100 is fine. I'm still not sure, you know. Well, that's if events ever happen again. But yeah, I was never planning on taking the C200 to events anyway.
Oh, okay.
Also, yeah, like I wouldn't take like an EOS R or another mirrorless. I still like the advantage of having a cinema camera at events over a mirrorless.
It's just quicker setup with a cinema camera versus with EOS R's. Like, yeah, it's a smaller body, but all the attachment that you have to, you know, put on is just as heavy when you take it.
Yeah. So. The C200 really is just meant to stay in the studio for what we do.
Nice that we have new toys, though.
Yeah, actually, the last EOS R is getting delivered today, and then I got a couple of the EF to RF lens adapters. One of them is the... Sorry, guy. That's Alien Jimmy.
Alien Jimmy?
Yeah. Don't hurt Alien Jimmy. I got one with that adds the control ring, like a third ring to EF glass, which is fun. And then the one that adds the variable ND, which is great. So then you don't have to put a variable ND on the lens itself. It's mostly useful for video.
Wait, what's a variable ND for those of us who have no idea how this works?
So a neutral density filter is essentially sunglasses for a camera. And variable just means, like, usually ND is like a physical thing that's screwed onto the front of a lens. It's actually built into cinema cameras. I can actually see it. So, yeah, I just activated the ND filters. It's literally swapping out little like lenses in front of it. But a variable ND is nice because it uses a variable nature. It doesn't flip through multiple stops. It kind of does a gradation of it.
Oh, I see what you mean about the sunglasses thing. That's cute.
Yeah, it's literally, you know, swapping in. It's almost like going to the eye doctor. And you know how they like sit there with the thing on in front of your eye, and then they cycle through different lenses in front of it. That's kind of how it's implemented on here. It's not the same for everything. Like I said, most of it screws onto the front of a lens, especially for photographers. But that's one thing that Canon did get right with this new mirrorless system is that variable ND attachment. It's expensive though. So yeah, I mean in that case, really one of the bigger downsides, you know, versus a cinema camera at that point is XLR, true XLR inputs. Which I mean that means a lot when you're on the road too, especially since we usually mic up two people. If you're just micing up one person, you can get away with it just putting it on a mirrorless, but two people? I don't like to roll with separate recorders on my mirrorless system. It kind of defeats the purpose.
It's like Willis was saying, right? Like, you have to deck out all of it with extras that it adds up anyway.
Yeah, but hey, listen, it's great that the option is there, and especially for price-conscious
Absolutely.
People. Like, hell yeah. I mean, what you've been able to achieve, you know, since the 5D Mark II is just amazing, given the price.
Well, 5D is not mirrorless, or isn't it just the standard SLR, isn't it?
Yeah, but that's kind of, you know, when the turning point happened for DSLRs to be able to shoot video, or, you know, in a way that was filmic.
You guys bumped up to heroic, right? You're not on normal anymore.
I think we're still on normal.
Are you?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think I've changed it.
I thought you did last stream.
Did I? Oops. That's our guy.
That's good. Are you shooting at Willis again?
Nope. Just our little grunt friend.
Alien Frank and Jimmy.
Yeah.
And Jimmy.
Man, you just went in there, dude.
I didn't see them.
That's like a closet full of horrors that you just went into. Yeah. Anyway, new toys are always fun. And some of those new toys are waiting for you in the office, Elena.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Oh, damn it. Shot another one of our teammates. Oh, man. The welcoming party. What's going on, guys? Yeah, okay. That was easy.
Oh, we got so many allies behind us.
I know. I had no idea we were amassing an army. I really don't remember the later parts of this game.
Well, that's still more than I remember. Which is zero.
I just remember it ends on a cliffhanger because then everyone had to wait for Halo 3. Sorry, yeah. Spoilers.
I think Troll McTrollerton, I forgot the full name, still a great username, though, even though I'm butchering it, had mentioned that. They're like, oh, isn't this the one that ends in a cliffhanger? And I meant to get back to that comment, but then I got distracted.
Yes, the music kicks in.
This music. Are you pumped, Adam?
Oh,
music?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, I would say I got a little down after that first Arbiter level. I forgot just how much of a pain that Arbiter level was, but ever since then, I mean, we've been on a good tear. Now we got an army of ghosts here rolling through your town. They see me rolling.
Now they just need, like, shades.
Yeah. They need some ND filters for the face.
Oh, I love this idea.
What?
Oh, how would we do it? Rick Elder just said that we should get a dead console and build a gaming PC in it and then just play games on that in the office.
Oh.
Yeah, no, it's been done before. I've definitely seen some mods. God, what was the... I sent one to you a couple weeks ago.
I kind of feel like an original Xbox would have the most room because it's so chunky.
It was an NES.
So maybe that... Oh, yeah, but see, no, that one was ghetto, dude. Like,
ghetto.
I watched that...
I mean, he fit a 2060 in there. It's not going to stay cool, but
no.
He did it. I thought it was cool.
No. No, he didn't finish the build.
Oh, he didn't?
And he had to... No, and he had to figure out a way to, like, get extra... to do a lift, basically.
Oh.
To make it fit. And, like, the way he crammed that thing in there is just painful. I can't. Oh, I can't. So, no, I'd rather find something like an original Xbox or even Xbox 360 and try that because I think it might work. Ooh, I don't want to do this.
It feels like something Linus has done. Also, I'll say we've been meaning to, and maybe this is a good way to kind of roll back into live builds, is RetroFlag has some new cases. And I've been meaning to upgrade upgrade to the new Raspberry Pi on my RetroPi.
Yeah, I was a friend of mine who does RetroPi who did RetroPi build was saying that the Raspberry Pi 4 is capable of like Dreamcast level emulation.
What?
I think.
No,
yeah.
Come on, don't tell me that.
Why wouldn't I tell you that?
Don't tell
it's like
me
perfect
that.
For you.
No.
It's like perfect for you.
Stop.
I mean, where are you going to go during these shelter-in-place days? You may as well just play a bunch of Dreamcast games that you haven't played in decades.
Dude, man, you know, I haven't looked. I need to look on further onto the site, but if RetroFlag has a Dreamcast, a mini Dreamcast case for RetroPie, I'm buying, like, a case of them. I'm buying out the whole stock. Hell yeah. I mean, if there was a... It wouldn't work because I think it's too small, but if there was a console that I could mod and put a PC in, it would definitely be the Dreamcast. I love that box.
But would you really want to gut one that way?
Yeah, I mean, they're not hard to find. They're, you know, it's still relatively prevalent. Oh, wow. I don't know what got me. I'm dead.
And then, Brandon Hussey on YouTube. I don't think the game actually did look this pretty. I think some people might remember it this way, but this has definitely been prettied up for a PC. So if at some point Adam wants to switch to the classic view, you will see.
I will do that once
we'll
I spawn
back
in. Oh, you found some human weapons? Lucky.
Yeah, but I can't spawn in right now, or have you spawn in, even though I'm kind of safe.
Yeah, it's always proximity to how close you are to the nearest enemy. But yeah, once I spawn in, I'll switch back to original graphics, because, yeah, it definitely looks different. Also, Elena, did you see... oh my goodness. My brain's literally frying like an egg.
This is your brain on drugs.
Yes. Digital Foundry did a review of the Ghost Canyon Nook. Did you watch that by any chance?
I did see they had it. It's in my list of things that I need to catch up on watching. I have not watched it yet, though.
Yeah. I haven't watched it yet. I was just curious to see if you had seen it. And what you thought of it. And, you know, Digital Foundry usually does pretty good coverage, but when they do like PC hardware stuff, it's usually a little more sporadic than their console stuff. So.
Yeah, I haven't really looked at much of their PC coverage, so yeah, I'm gonna get to it at some point. It's really impressive to me that Brad can just watch like Twitch streams and listen to things while he's like writing and editing, because for me, I can't concentrate when there's like human voices talking. Like, music's okay, but if people are actually having conversation, I get so distracted.
Oh no, I got stuck.
Oh no.
Oh no, I'm still alive. Man, how is this ghost still going? Dang. This ghost is literally on its last legs. But somehow, it's trucking along. The essence of Halo is alive in this ghost. Don't let me down, you little ghost. Oh no, back up. Whew. Oh no, I'm down. I'm down. You know, I feel
every time
like... I was just going to say, I feel like one of the things that's missing from Halo 4 and 5 is more vehicle combat, now that I think about it. And maybe that's not true, maybe I'm misremembering, but yeah.
Well, I... 4, I think there's a little less of it, yeah. But I think 5, they got really preoccupied with the whole, like, let's mantle.
Oh, I forgot to turn it. Okay, here's the original graphics for the people who are asking.
What you doing, Willis?
He's, you know.
You know, trying not to catch on fire. I can't enter this thing.
Ah, I died.
Hello. Are you back?
I'm back. Man, it's hot in here. Whoa. And I'm done. Jeez.
Hosting.
Yeah, it's like one of those things where it's on a stream. Like, do you even run a fan? Like, it just seems like you might just pollute the audio stream with the fan noise in the background. Right?
Actually, so. This mic is not too bad for background noise. But I do just realize that I had turned off the fan. Oh my god, I'm dead again. I turned off the fan when I went to go film earlier and forgot to turn it back on because I like immediately had to sit up for this. Like, I literally tore everything down to be able.
I mean,
to use
I'm pretty
the
sure the stream wouldn't mind if you paused for a second to turn on.
I'm
fan,
dead
dude.
Anyway. So.
You're back.
Oh, I love this. Troll McTrollington says, in Halo, I always hated the idea of punching a tank to death, unless I was the one punching it to death.
Okay, I'm back. Let's see.
Oh, yeah, level. Jack Mayhoff. That sounds... I mean, yeah, we could probably try RTX voice to deal with the fan noise.
I just turned it on. I don't think anyone's going to hear it. It's not that bad.
Yeah, I can't hear anything myself.
Also, you know what? If you're going to complain about it, F you. It's hot out. I don't care.
Are you wearing pants or shorts?
I'm wearing shorts.
Okay.
But the shirt is like, a little thicker.
Willis, question for you from VC Jester.
Hey,
what's up?
He says, we never ask how Willis is doing because he just hides out in the shadows. Oh, he called you out, man. So, Willis, how have you been, young man?
Okay. Young man?
I know.
Very young man.
Not so young, right? I've been good.
You can't tell his true age.
No. He's
easily the youngest on staff.
Am I?
I think so, right? I don't think there's anyone else who's... Yeah, no.
No, I've been accidentally threw a grenade. My bad. Been good.
Did you just shoot your friendly teammates in the head, Adam?
Hey, you know, going for those headshots. I gotta practice.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry, Willis. Please go ahead.
How did you do that, Adam? No, just been hanging out home, working from home, keeping safe, healthy, and all the good stuff.
Can I tell you guys something embarrassing yesterday?
Sure.
It's not potty embarrassing. Don't worry. we were going to get sushi. We were like, you know what? Well, what's something that's a little cooler? Let's get some raw fish. Some cool raw fish. But the place we wanted to go to wasn't answering the phones. So I was like, maybe it's the holiday. You know, maybe they have weird hours. I have no idea. So Lindsay was like, well, we need sushi ASAP. So what's the nearest place we can just walk to, just order? And I was like, all right. So I searched for something and I found it, put in an order. I was like, all right, let's do it. Perfect timing. Just go straight to it, pick it up. And I get there on Google Maps and I'm like, okay, I know it's between a Wiener Schnitzel and a Circle K, but I'm standing at where it's supposed to be, but it's like a residential, it's like a house. And I'm like, is somebody literally making sushi out of their house? And I was like, no, this isn't it. We've got to be, oh, maybe it's across the street. We looked across the street, couldn't find anything. And I was like, what the hell? It looks like it's right here. And I zoomed in even further and it said the name of the place. It was literally a sushi place in Circle K. We walk in and it's just like, and we walk in and it's just in the corner of this Circle K, like two dudes just making cheap ass sushi. And I looked at Lindsay and I was just like, I mean, we spent like $40 on sushi, you know, should we just call this just say, hey, you know what, let's not do this. Let's call it even and just walk away. But no, we ended up eating it. I'm not dead. So,
oh my god, you survived gas station sushi?
I didn't know it was going to be in a gas station.
Oh my gosh.
I just literally got the first thing that was on Google Maps.
Oh no.
You just ran with it?
But no, and it's not like it's like it was pre-made sushi that's at a gas station. It was literally two dudes in the corner of the Circle K with their own little sushi bench and everything, you know. It was a legit operation.
Okay, how was it?
No, it wasn't good. I've made better sushi.
I was hoping you were going to be like, oh, you know, it actually turned out to be like gas station fried chicken. Actually not terrible.
Well, yeah. Lindsay even said like, hey, even if this tastes amazing, we're never doing that again. And I was like, oh yeah, totally. They were like,
no, Lindsay's right.
Tiny. They just had no flavor. Like, I mean, we're not dead. We didn't get food poisoning. I think we would have got it by now, hopefully.
It takes up to 12 hours, I think.
I mean, yeah, that was dinner time, so yeah, that's still time. We were just so close to being like, you know what? Let's just give it to this homeless guy right here and order more sushi from the place we
and
know.
Let him? That's terrible. You're just going to give food poisoning to a homeless person?
I would have told
they
him.
They probably don't even have health insurance.
I would have been like, hey, we got sushi here. We don't want it. Do you want it? You know, he doesn't have to eat it. I wasn't going to be like, hey, this is really nice sushi.
Did you tell him it was gas station sushi, though?
Yeah, I mean, it's the Bay Area.
We didn't give it to him. We ate it. Because Lindsay was like,
I bet even the homeless people would know better.
He's like, oh, you got it from there? Dude. anyway, so that's my story. I say we stop here because I'm hot. It sounds like we might be able to stream again tomorrow. So yeah, I'm gonna stop the game, Willis. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna
until
end game. Until tomorrow, I would say, yeah, let's see it, because I think we're 13 out of 15 completed, so we literally have two more left.
Yeah, you're really close.
Yeah, I think we
can do
tomorrow.
It tomorrow.
I'm fine with that. So, that's Halo 2. We'll conclude tomorrow, and then, I'm excited to get Brad on to play some multiplayer then after that.
Yeah, the plan is that we're going to do four-player competitive multiplayer.
Teaming up.
On Friday, and Brad will be in a game stream with us finally.
Hopefully. Yeah, this is the week of the Halo. Thank you everybody. for hanging out with us during this heat wave. I need to go drink some water. And go sit in front of the
go
fan over
out.
There for a little bit and turn off this. It's an LED. It's not even that bright, but it's still like, you know, shining on my face, which is not always fun. So anyway, thank you all. Thank you, Willis, for continuing the Halo journey. And thank you, Elena, for manning the chat, which is very important, very unspoken hero kind of status there. So, stay safe, everybody, and we will see you tomorrow.